Well, actually, it has to do with stimulating mTOR and getting muscle protein synthesis. Let's say she can only right now do 2 meals a day where she gets 30 grams of protein. I think it would be better for her to only get 60 grams of protein a day, but if that's in 2 meals at 30 grams a piece, I think that's probably better than getting even 80 or 90 grams where it's like 10 grams here, 15 grams here, 12 grams here, 8 grams there. And it's like all spaced kind of throughout the day.
It has to do with her age.
Well, actually it has to do with stimulating mTOR and getting muscle protein synthesis. And so our first phase of protocols with her was really on actually getting mTOR a little bit suppressed, right? We're on sirolimus. We are trying to get some autophagy and some senolysis in there because there's a lot of senescent cells associated with osteoarthritis. Now is time to push mTOR. We want that stimulation. And so we want to make sure that when she's doing branch chains or like our tissue hyperemia stuff is minimum 3 grams of leucine, which we have that in there already. So we're stimulating mTOR there. But then with each meal, making sure that we're getting 30 grams of protein. And so that conversation with her will be really on what's diet look like right now in terms of volume. Because eating for her, eating 30 grams of protein in a single sitting might be a lot because she's trained herself to eat smaller amounts, potentially more frequently throughout the day.